My name is Bethany, and this is my channel, Bethany's Thoughts. And today I'm going to be talking about my February TBR. I'm really excited to announce that I'm going to be participating in the Black Author Readathon. This is hosted by a slew of people, a slew of Black creators. I love that they're all doing it. It's a combination of Instagrammers and BookTubers. I will link announcements and who's participating in the description below, and you can see who that is and check them out. I'm really excited about it. I do have, before I get into the TBR that I have planned for that, I do am doing two buddy reads for this month. They are not Black authors, because I already had these planned ahead of time before everything, before the Black Author Readathon. So they're included in my February TBR. So to start off with, we're doing Siege and the Storm by Leigh Bardugo. This is the second book, Shadow and Bone trilogy. I just started the Shadow and Bone audiobook, and I have the second book in hardcover, so I'm really interested. It started off really interesting, and so I'm really excited to continue with the series, and with the hype of the TV show coming out in April, like, I gotta get reading. I really want to see it, and I really want to read the series before the TV show comes out on Netflix. And the pictures came out, book Twitter went wild, so it's very exciting times. And the next one I have planned, which I've been meaning to read all last year and hadn't gotten a chance to, and that is The House in the Cerulean Sea by T.J. Klune. And this is basically queer romance, but it's about a guy who goes to a house full of misfit kids that have strange, very intense abilities, and there's all sorts of things ensue from there. I've heard just rave reviews about this book, and I really, really want to read it, and I'm excited for it. So one of the best descriptions I've heard of it, and I'm sure it's well-fitting, but one of the best descriptions I heard of it is it's middle grade for adults, and it gives you a hug. It's a warm hug. Both those things I love, so I'm really excited about it, and that's why I'm doing a buddy read for that. Those are the two that I'm buddy reading. One of them's for a Discord group, and one of them is I'm buddy reading with my cousin, so it'll be fun. Now let's get into more of the things for Black Author Readathon. So there's a ton of prompts. It's like a bingo board. I might post it here, which is a lot of fun. I love bingo boards. Bingo boards are great. So I'm not sure if I'm going to read everything. I'm not going to go through every prompt because I don't have a book for every prompt. I have several books that cover most of these. Some of them cover two or three different prompts. I'm going to go over the books that I have, and then I will mention which prompts they cover in the bingo board. The first prompt is a novella. I'm going to be reading The Pursuit Of by Courtney Milan. That is a enemies to lovers, male-male romance. I had it on my TBR for Smutathon, did not get a chance to get to it, and I already purchased it, so I thought it would fit this perfectly. And Black author. I have not read Courtney Milan yet, and I've heard really great things about her, so I'm really excited to get into that one. Next, I have, for a workplace romance, I have Naughty Boss by Whitney G. I've read one of Whitney G's before, and she's a Black author. Naughty Boss, if I remember correctly, Riley Marie read it for Smutathon as well. This is also novella length. And she sends a email that is not intended to go to the boss about her complaining about him. And I'm always here for that. That's always just like an awkward situation like that is always really fun for me to read. I was really intrigued, and I think that'll be a lot of fun, so I'm looking forward to doing that. I believe that's on Kindle Unlimited. The next one for age gap romance, I have If She Says Yes by Tasha Harrison. I saw this recommended on Twitter, actually. It is an age gap romance between younger man. I want to say he's graduating high school? College? I think he's graduating college. And he wants to try to pursue his best friend's mom. So I just thought that was really intriguing and really interested. And it's a Black author. I haven't read Tasha Anderson before. I'm also using that for my forbidden taboo dark romance prompt because it's more for on the forbidden side. So I'm really excited for that one. That should be fun. I believe that one's also novella length. I have for child to grown romance. That usually is a romance that is they grow up together as children and then they have like a big break and then they meet again when they're grown up. And for that, I'm going to be reading another Courtney Milan. This is The Duke Who Didn't. And basically their childhood sweethearts, I guess he is supposed to be with her And he ends up leaving, and then he comes back to, like, win her back. And little does she know that he's, like, the duke of, like, her entire province. I love this cover also so much. So I'm really, really excited for it. And I am really looking forward to reading this. I bought this in my book haul from The Ripped Bodice, the romance bookstore in LA. And this is one I bought in person, so that was very exciting. So yeah, I'm really, really excited to finally get in and read that one. I think it only covers, I think I only have it covering one. Oh, it might also cover second chance romance as well. And then for historical romance, I'm going to be reading this one for my real life book club in person, except we don't meet in person, we meet on Zoom, but we're going to be reading A Rebel by Beverly Jenkins. So I'm really excited to read another one by Queen Bev. I've read a few of hers before and I've really enjoyed her. She just kills historical romance. So I'm really, really excited about that. I don't even really remember what it's about. No, it happens. I do remember it. It happens in New Orleans. I think that's all I remember. I don't really need to know descriptions at this point. I'm like, Queen Bev, I'll just read it. Anyway, it'll be fun. I think this will be great, though. It's a historical, it's set in New Orleans. I'm really excited to see kind of what the historical vibe is from New Orleans, because I think it's a city that has a lot of rich history, so super excited for it. It's just going to be great. For Rockstar Romance, I'm going to be reading Flow and maybe Grip. This is a, Grip series is a series from Kennedy Ryan. It is a Rockstar Romance. He's a musician, and I believe she's his manager. And so Flo is the prequel where they have, like, a week that they, like, basically hook up and have some good times. And then Grip is the book of them continuing on in their story without, like, they set aside their romance to be just, like, just to be able to work together. And I guess things come out from there. And Kennedy Ryan is a Black author. I've read her before, too. She has really, her books are heavy, but, like, in a good way. Like, she deals with, like, heavier topics, really hard-hitting emotional, deep emotions. It's not fluff. It's not your fluffy read, but I'm really excited. I've heard really good things about the series. I'm going to be listening to this on audiobook. My Libby app has it for audio. So I'm going to start with Flo. Flo is the prequel, and Flo is, I'm assuming, more novella length. Grip is the longer novel, so I'm definitely going to read Flo. But I'm going to just see if I can get to Grip. That's kind of my plan for now. The next book I'm going to be reading is The Boyfriend Project. This is the prompt that fits this is a friend group series. And this is by, if I can read my handwriting, Farah Roshin? I can't even read this. My handwriting's terrible, guys, though. Like, look at this. This is just nonsense. Anyway, why do I write these clear? I'm really excited about that one. Basically, I think if I remember correctly, she swears off men and then she meets her coworker and she starts connecting with the coworker. I forget what the project is involved, but there's like a friend group that she gives up men entirely. Oh, I remember what it was. It was about, they were all like with the same guy. I think that's what it is. And they all swear off men after they've like been duped by this guy, and she's sworn off men and then she meets her coworker and they start feeling vibes against each other. That one I'm also listening to on audio. I'm really excited about that one. I've heard really good things about that one. So, and it's an author I have not read. The next one is going to be Black Shot by Kennedy Ryan as well. This is for the prompt realistic contemporary. So that's a hard-hitting contemporary. Again, Kennedy Ryan, I feel like she does that a lot. Black Shot is also something I've had on my Kindle Unlimited for months. I started it and I had a hard time with it because it does have cheating, which is not my favorite thing in a novel. I started it and I wasn't really getting into it. I just wasn't in the mood for that kind of story. So I dropped it. But I really still want to know kind of how it all works out for them, because I am invested in that couple. So I'm going to go back and I want to finish it. I did find out that it's on Libby, so I can not have to keep it on my Kindle Unlimited. I can get it on Libby and listen to it, and I'll probably be able to finish it a lot quicker for me. I've noticed that things that I have a hard time like sitting down and physically reading, I can do better on audio. And so the next one I have is fantasy paranormal romance. So this is kind of paranormal-ish. So this is The Opposite of Always by Justin Reynolds. It's a YA romance. I have not read Justin Reynolds before, so that's kind of exciting. Opposite of Always is basically, it's about a young man who meets a girl, and I want to say within a week she dies. And then he gets stuck in a time loop. He goes back and relives his week of him meeting this girl and seeing if he can change the story. After In Holidays, I feel like I need a really good time loop book. And right now, I don't know, that's like a thing that I'm really into. So I'm really intrigued. I really want to listen to it. I have it available on Libby on audio. So I'm really looking forward to checking that out. I have not read Justin Reynolds before. I know he's a really popular author, so I'm looking forward to it. Technically, it can also be considered a second chance romance. So next prompt is fake dating romance. So for this one, I'm going to be reading My Darling Duke by Stacey Reed. It's a historical romance. I love this cover. I'm also obsessed with purple, so this is why I love the cover. It is about a young woman who is trying to get her family. Yes, she's trying to get her sisters married off and to save her family. And so she decides to pretend engage herself to a duke that is no longer a part of society. Like, he doesn't show up in person. So she just decides to, like, I'm just going to pretend to be his fiance and get really good matches for my sister. And she kind of creates her whole persona around herself. And he's like a recluse. Like, no one ever sees him. So she thinks she can get away with it. And then the duke shows up. Why do I love that type of trope? Why? It's just so great. There's just something so fun about it. So, and then hijinks ensue. So, it seems like a lot of fun. I'm really looking forward to it. I've heard really good things about Stacey Reed. I haven't heard anything by her before. So, very excited about that. Friends to Lovers. I thought I had a Friends to Lovers prompt. I guess I don't. It could be The Duke Who Didn't can account for that one. As well as Fumbled by Alexa Martin, which is something I'm planning on reading. That could count for that one, too. Yeah, I'm going with those. Then we have, for Enemies to Lovers prompt, I'm going to be reading Sweet Talkin' Lover by Tracy Livesay. Obviously, it's another purple cover. This is why I have it. It's gorgeous. I'm really excited about this one. It's also a friends group series. And there's this one and I can't remember the name for the other one. I'm blanking. I'll put the cover here. And I have both of them, actually. I have that one in ebook. I have this one in physical. I might try to get to both of them. We'll see how it goes. But I'm definitely planning on this one for sure. Enemies to Lovers. It basically sounds like a Hallmark movie to me, which I love. So basically she is like part of big business. She comes to this small town to like shut down the warehouse plant that they have there. And the mayor kind of gets in her way, but then chemistry happens and I'm here for it. And it sounds really good. And I'm really excited about reading it and checking it out. I already mentioned when I have our second chance romance, new to you Black author. So several of these are new to me. Courtney Milan, as I mentioned, Tasha Harrison, Farrah Roshan, Tracy Livesay, Cherish Reed is something else I have later in my TBR. That's already five. So I have several that are new to me, Black authors. I really tried to add people that I've been wanting to read for a while that I just haven't gotten to, or things that I already physically bought, so that I wanted to focus on for this TBR. So I'm really, really excited. So I have several authors for that prompt, which is very fun and exciting. Next one is single parent romance. So for that one, I'm going to be using Fumbled by Alexa Martin, but it is a football series. I read Intercepted and I really enjoyed it. And, but I'm really excited about Fumbled because I really liked the football character from that one. The fact that Alexa Martin was a football wife is really, really fun. I really love that. So she definitely has an insight into how the girlfriends and wives, deal with the players. I think that's something fun. I really enjoyed the first book. This is the second book in the series. I am really excited to read that one. I have that one in ebook. And that also fills the prompt for a sports romance. So two for one on that one. Next, I have interracial romance. Several of these are actually interracial. I want to say, let's see. For sure, I know The Portrait Of by Courtney Milan. I want to say Block Shot is also interracial. Fumbled, I believe, might be interracial. Opposite of Always, I believe, might be interracial. So several of these count as interracial. The one I'm counting for, and then another one that I'm counting for interracial as well, is An Extraordinary Union by Alyssa Cole. This is her first book of her Loyal League series. I read the second book. I read them out of order. I read the second book. I'm going back to read the first one. It is about a Black woman and a white man, and they are during the Civil War. They're spies. So I'm also counting this for the romantic suspense prompt. I'm not a huge romance suspense fan. That's not usually a thing. Like, it's like it's thriller meet romance, and the romance to me is never usually enough for that. It's never usually enough for the plot. I don't know. Anyway, maybe I'm just being particular. It's not usually a genre I really care for. But I think that the fact that they're like Civil War spies And the second book was pretty intense. I mean, you would expect from a romance book that's set in the Civil War, there could be, you know, a little bit heavier subject material. So I think it fits in romance suspense enough. So I'm gonna work with that. I hope that's okay. I'm using that one for that prompt. I think it fits close enough. We'll see. Once I read it, maybe I'll know no more. So, and then I'm really excited to share that I took a while to find one. Thanks to all of the hosts for posting their TBRs, I was able to find a Black author for a romance graphic novel, because there's not a lot of Black artists or writers that are doing comics or graphic novels, really, which obviously is another, I mean, books in general as well. So obviously that's another genre that needs more representation. But I learned that Check Please by Ngozi Okazu is a Black author, and I've been meaning to read Check Please. So I'm really excited about that. That is like a hockey queer romance, I believe. And also all of it's online. So that makes it even more fun that it's online. I didn't know if I was going to be able to purchase it in time for it to get here. So the fact that it's online makes it really easy, and then I can purchase it later. And then the next one also found out about is S. Murashita, is also a Black author, and she does more like manga type stuff. And she also has a website that are free, able to be read online. So super fun. I'll link those two in the description, and you can see those for yourself as well. The next one I have going to be reading is for the mature romance. So mature romance is for those who are 35 and older. I got this recommendation from Steph. I think it was Stephanie. This is Hearts on Hold by Cherish Reed. From the description, it sounds like up my alley. Hearts on Hold, she is a professor and she's trying to get the college to help fund something for the library. She's trying to get some sort of working relationship with the library. It is a male librarian, which I love so much, because usually I feel like every book has a female librarian. I don't think I've ever seen a male librarian in a book. I thought that was really fun. And it just sounded like something I was really into. And apparently she's like super straight and rigid and he's like really good with the flow. I think it's a dynamic that I really like as well. So I'm really looking forward to that one. That sounds like a lot of fun. I got that one on ebook. I think that's it. I'm really excited for this readathon. I'm really excited that I get to be a part of it. And then I'm really going to focus on all of the Black authors for February. As you may know, it's Black History Month. So also a really good reason to read more Black authors. I'm going to be honest, I've only really started reading diverse authors since about 2018 is when I really started getting into more of them. It started me with Alyssa Cole, and then I started meeting more authors as I got more involved into the genre. I think the only things that were really being published that I was exposed to is just trauma stories. And that's not the type of things that I like to read and the things I like to enjoy. So I think when I really discovered Black romance, starting with Alyssa Cole and then getting more involved in the genre from there and more involved in learning more about Black authors and really finding the Black romance and Black authors writing romance genre, being able to read these joyful stories about Black people, I enjoy so much more. So we don't have to read about trauma. You don't have to be able to enjoy Black authors. And I love it. It makes me so happy because I don't really want to read trauma stories. I mean, I think that they have a place too, obviously, but I think that there's enough of those published, and I love seeing just Black joy, and that makes me happy. So I'm really excited to read more of these and all the new authors I'm planning on reading and all the ones that I've still been working through their backlist. I'm really excited. If you're participating in the readathon, let me know down below what Black author or Black author book that you are going to be reading. I would love to know. And as well as, or just what book in February you plan on reading. I would love to know that as well. And that's it for me today. Thank you so much for watching. If you like what you saw and want to see more from me, please subscribe and like the video and bells. I would really appreciate it. And if you want to follow me on all the social medias below, I have those all linked down below and you can check me out on all the things. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you again soon. Bye!